was up with revision too.
So she had an emergency language and this language. We took this language out because that's the language that's there if you want to go for 30 days. Better than it was before.
Are we running? Okay. Ready? I now call the Norton City Council regular council meeting for Monday, May 13th, 2019 to order. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance and a moment of silent reflection.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Be seated, please. Will the clerk call the roll, please?
Mr. Gaynor?
Here.
Mr. McClown?
Here.
Mr. Carrant?
Here.
Mr. Towsley?
Here.
Ms. Whipke?
Here.
Mr. Pilott?
Here.
Mr. Kernan?
Here. Communications from the public. Did we have any sign up?
We did not.
Thank you. Under Committee of the Whole, any reports from the standing committees? All right. Hearing none, then I will acknowledge receipt of the April 2019 budget reports. Consideration of the minutes of the prior meetings, the minutes of the regular council meeting of April 22nd, 2019. Are there any additions, deletions, or corrections from those? Hearing none, then they'll be accepted as submitted. The minutes of the committee work session of May 6th, 2019. Are there any additions, deletions, or corrections to those? Hearing none, they will then be accepted as submitted. Reports from officers, boards, and commissions. Mayor Zita.
Thank you, Council President. At this time, I'll wait, and I will have public service announcements at the end of the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Fowler?
Yeah, I have a few items of note. Many of you may have noticed the paving contractor has started. Due to some weather and other issues, we're delayed about another week, so we'll be pushed back a week. They're not paving this week. But they are going to do some concrete repair in some of the neighborhoods. Just for your information, I know I sent out a memo on Friday on the Congo Road issue, trying to outline for you the city's stance on the Congo Road Bridge. You know, we've had many conversations with the county. The Ohio Revised Code is very clear. It articulates in the code that any span over 10 feet is considered a bridge, and a bridge in the revised code is defined as falling under the county engineer's obligation. So we're going to leave it at that. We've sent out emails today. Until the county proves to us otherwise, we consider the matter closed. We're going to leave the road closed until it's fixed by the county. So just thought I would make you all aware. We did put out some concrete barricades and try to make it more secure as the week progressed. Just to kind of let you know where we are, New Park Drive, Eastern Road, Cleveland-Maslin Road North Water and Sewer Line, and then the Cleveland-Maslin Road here in the square sewer line. We're going to be bidding those projects. Actually, three of them are out for bid presently. I intend to have Josh prepare the bid documents for the Cleveland-Maslin Road sewer here. We had asked Carvo to give us a price. They've been reluctant, so we have to bid it out separately. I think council would want us to complete that sewer and get out of the roadway before they come in and put the new road in. If I'm wrong, I hope you all would say, but I think you all want me to get that out of the way so that we're not cutting up some fresh pavement. So those will be out for bid. They're due back. Some of those bids are due back late this month. I imagine the first meeting in June, I'll have some information for you. My goal is to award those contracts the first and last meeting in July. So just wanted to kind of give you an update. Also, Johnson Road and Medina Line Road repair, that'll be going out for bid as well. So we kind of have a lot of projects that are in the pipeline, but I just kind of want to give you a heads up that those should be coming due, where we would award them before you all head to break in July so the construction can commence. And that's all.
Thank you. Mr. Messner?
Nothing at this time. Thank you.
Mr. Markey?
Nothing at this time. Thank you.
Thank you. We do have a public hearing scheduled for 7:15. So is that scheduled for 7:15? Is that correct?
Yep, correct.
Okay. So we're going to skip over that. We're going to move into introduction of new legislation, and then we'll come back to that. So ordinance number 58-2019, Mr. McGlone.
Thank you, Mr. President. I offer ordinance number 58-2019 for its first reading and ask the clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to amend section 258.15 of the codified ordinances of the city of Norton, Ohio.
First reading only.
Thank you. Ordinance number 59-2019, Mr. McGlone.
Thank you, Mr. President. I offer ordinance 59-2019 for its first reading. Ask the clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to amend section 276.06 of the codified ordinances of the city of Norton, Ohio.
First reading only.
Thank you. Ordinance number 60-2019, Mr. Gaynor.
Yes, I'd like to offer ordinance 60-2019. Have the clerk read it, please.
An ordinance to initiate the rezoning of property described as permanent parcel numbers 4600259 and 4604166 in the city from a C-REC district to a mixed-use district.
First reading only.
Thank you. Ordinance number 61-2019, Mr. Gaynor.
Offer 61-2019. Ask the clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to amend the zoning code of the city to implement the C1 zoning classification.
First reading only.
Thank you, Mr. Gaynor. Ordinance number 62-2019, Mr. McGlone.
Thank you, Mr. President. I offer ordinance 62-2019 for its first reading and ask the clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance determining to establish wage rates for seasonal employees and college interns.
First reading only.
Thank you. Ordinance number 63-2019, Ms. Wipke.
Thank you, Mr. President. I introduce ordinance 63-2019 for its first reading. Ask clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to authorize the administrative officer to enter into an agreement with Environmental Design Group for professional engineering services in connection with the design of a walking path improvements in Columbia Woods Park in an amount not to exceed $27,500.
First reading only.
Thank you. Ordinance number 64-2019. Ms. Wipke.
Thank you, Mr. President. Before I get started on this, I'd just like to let everybody know that ordinances 64, 65, and 66 have all been corrected as they needed to have the emergency language added at the end. It had been overlooked, and so even though it was in the title, so they've all got emergency language in them, and council has copies of the reworded ordinances in front of them. At this time, I introduce ordinance 64-2019 for its first reading. Ask clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to authorize the administrative officer to enter into an agreement with Environmental Design Group for professional engineering services in connection improvements to Barber Road in an amount not to exceed $55,000 and declaring an emergency.
Okay. As we really need to get started on this, if we haven't already, I'm now going to motion to waive the second and third readings for Ordinance 64-2019.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second for waiver of the second and third readings. Is there any comment regarding the waiver? Would the clerk call the roll, please?
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilot?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes.
Thank you. This time I motion to adopt Ordinance 64-2019.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second to adopt Ordinance Number 64-2019. Is there any further discussion? Would the clerk call the roll, please?
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilot?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes.
Thank you.
Ordinance Number 65-2019, Ms. Wipke.
Thank you, Mr. President. I introduce Ordinance 65-2019 for its first reading. Ask clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to authorize the administrative officer to enter into an agreement with GPD Group for professional engineering services in connection with the construction management and inspection of the 2019 road program in an amount not to exceed $29,890 and declaring an emergency.
Thank you. As we've actually already started implementing this, at this time I'm going to make a motion to waive the second and third readings.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second to waive the second and third readings of Ordinance Number 65-2019. Is there any discussion regarding waiver only? Would the clerk call the roll, please?
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilot?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes.
This time I motion to adopt Ordinance 65-2019.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second to adopt Ordinance Number 65-2019. Is there any further discussion? Would the clerk call the roll, please?
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilot?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes. Ordinance Number 66-2019, Ms. Wipke.
Thank you, Mr. President. I introduce Ordinance 66-2019 for its first reading. Ask clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to adopt a credit card policy for the city and declaring an emergency.
Thank you. Again, seeing as how we should have been implementing this if we haven't already, and it was a state-mandated item from November of last year, I motion to waive the second and third readings.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second to waive the second and third readings of Ordinance Number 66-2019. Is there any further discussion regarding waiver? Would the clerk call the roll, please?
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilot?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes.
At this time, I motion to adopt Ordinance 66-2019.
I'll second.
The motion and a second to adopt Ordinance Number 66-2019. Is there any further discussion? Would the clerk call the roll, please?
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilot?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes. Moving on to introduction of prior legislation, can we go ahead and have the second reading on the rezone?
I think that's fine.
Okay. All right. Ordinance Number 49-2019, Mr. Gaynor.
Yes, I'd like to offer 49-2019 for its second reading only.
An ordinance rezoning property described as permanent parcel numbers 46-02628, 46-08579, 46-08865, and 46-08866 from an R3 RPC district to an I-1 district.
Second reading only.
Thank you, Mr. Gaynor. Ordinance Number 47-2019. Mr. Carrant.
Thank you, Mr. President. At this time, I'd like to offer Ordinance Number 47-2019 for its third reading and ask the clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance providing consent to the Ohio Department of Transportation regarding the project designated as PID 107-165 and declaring an emergency.
At this time, I'd like to move on that motion, 47-2019, for approval.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to adopt Ordinance 47-2019. Is there any further discussion regarding the ordinance? Would the clerk call the roll, please?
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Pilot?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan.
Yes. Ordinance number 48-2019, Mr. McGlone.
Thank you, Mr. President. I offer ordinance 48-2019 for third reading. Ask clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance determining to amend the certain non-bargaining unit salary rates and wages and declaring an emergency.
I move to adopt ordinance 48-2019.
A second.
Motion and a second to adopt ordinance number 48-2019. Is there any further discussion?
Yes, Mr. President. These are three non-bargaining employees that are receiving raises this year, which is retroactive for the first of the year. The first one be Carrie McCumber, clerk of council, for getting her CMC certification. Administrative assistant Shannon Shetzley, did I say that right? Okay, she's got more responsibility this year with the boards and commissions. She'll be going to $48,000. And service department manager Larry Hess got a new position of management at the service department, and he'll be receiving $61,000.
Is there any further discussion? Will the clerk call the roll, please?
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Ms. Whipke?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Pilot?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes. Ordinance number 50-2019, Ms. Whipke.
Mr. President.
Oh, I'm sorry. We're at 7:15, aren't we? I'm going to back up, and we're going to go to our public meeting. Thank you, Mr. Towsley. Before I convene the public meeting, I just want to let everyone know that they'll have an opportunity to speak. There's a five-minute limit on your comments. Just to let everyone know that this is not a question-and-answer session. This is your opportunity to bring any concerns or support that you might have for the legislation, the public hearing, to council so that we can hear what you have to say. If you do have any questions that you would like answered, I would encourage you to give a written copy to the clerk of council. We'll get it to the appropriate person and get an answer to you. Also, if you read from a prepared statement, we're going to ask that you give a copy to the clerk of council so that it can be included in the minutes. Okay? I now declare the public hearing convened on ordinance number 49-2019. Ordinance number 49-2019 is an ordinance rezoning property described as permanent parcel numbers 4602628, 4608579, 4608865, and 4608866 from an R3 RPC district to an I1 district. Would the clerk please certify the legal notice was published in the Barberton Herald on April 18th, 2019?
I hereby certify that the legal notice for this public hearing was published in the Barberton Herald on April 18th, 2019, and that notices to all of the contiguous property owners were mailed on April 19th, 2019.
Thank you. Is there anyone who wishes to speak for the said zoning? Rezoning, I guess it is. For the second time, is there anyone who wishes to speak for the said rezoning? For the third and final time, is there anyone who wishes to speak for the said rezoning? Is there anyone who wishes to speak against the said rezoning? For the second time, is there anyone who wishes to speak against the said rezoning? For the third and final time, is there anyone who wishes to speak against the said rezoning? I now declare the public hearing closed. Moving back to our regular agenda, ordinance number 50-2019, Ms. Whipke.
Thank you, Mr. President. I offer ordinance 50-2019 for its third reading. Ask clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance authorizing the purchase of real property from the Board of Park Commissioners of Summit Metro Parks and declaring an emergency.
At this time, I motion to adopt ordinance 50-2019.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second to adopt ordinance number 50-2019. Is there any further discussion?
Yes, Mr. President.
Mr. Towsley?
I just would like to make a statement on this myself. For the 6 years that I've been representing Ward 4, very often people will come to the podium and tell us we need to build our tax base. We need to bring businesses in the city. So I've heard that on the contrary, I've also heard residents come forward. I've spoken at length with several residents. So this is one of the more difficult decisions that I've come across since I've been on council, because I see both sides and I don't take it lightly. What probably pushes my decision tonight is the fact that I'm concerned about spending residents' money with risk involved. The nature of the whole public transaction makes it so that we can't really secure businesses before, but that also adds risk. So if this should pass tonight, I'm all on board. I think it's a great opportunity, and I will work with the administration. I will work to try to protect residents, but I will be voting no on this tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Towsley. Is there any other comments from council? Any further discussion? You know, I'll just say I've lived in this city for some time. So many times I've heard of the different times that we've passed opportunities by in this city. So many times. We can't afford to do that anymore. We simply can't afford to do that. You know, Norton's gotten left behind while Wadsworth has prospered and Green has prospered, and it seems like every municipality around us has prospered. But we don't grasp the opportunity when we have it. And we have an opportunity here. And is there risk involved? There's always risk involved when we do something. The only risk that's not involved is when you don't do anything. And we see where that's gotten us so far. You know, we talk about expanding the tax base. We talk about wanting to take some of the burden off of the residents for the taxes that the residents pay in this town. And the only way we're going to do that is to expand the tax base. I understand the concerns of the people around that property. I've also talked with them. I am more than committed to work with them and take reasonable actions to help mitigate any difficulties they have with this. But really, at this point, the greater good of the city of Norton needs to prevail. And we need to stop saying, well, we'll do it the next time. We'll get it the next time. It's now. That time is now. Any further discussion?
Yes, Mr. President.
Ms. Wipke?
I totally agree with what our president just stated. It's past time. I don't want to be hearing, if I'm still here, in the future about how council or administration refuse to do anything to get business here, invite them in, or get this city moving in any way, shape, or form. This is our time to do something. I'm 150% behind this. I think it's a great move on our part. And for a change, it's Norton's turn to shine.
Any further discussion?
Yes, Mr. President.
Mr. Caron.
As past chairman of the Business Development Task Force, I'm at the heart of this, although I haven't been actively involved. And I totally agree with what you said. Having been to see some of the properties and the development locations, my concern is, first of all, this is really just authorizing the city to make the purchase. But when it comes to how that is organized, distributed, sold, I would like to work with councilor, whoever, to protect the interests of the residents to the best of our ability. They've appealed to us to do that. I think that's the best we can do, is to work towards some amicable solution, if at all possible.
Thank you, Mr. Caron. Any further discussion?
Yes, Mr. President. I will have to say that I've ran many a time saying I wanted to get new businesses into Norton, and I'm really excited to see something like this come up about to adopt and get this moving on. And I really want to say thanks to the administration for what they've done to get this here. I mean, I've been here 16 years now, and this last 2 years, what this administration has done to get new businesses here has been unbelievable, and I hope this continues on.
Thank you. Further discussion?
Mr. President.
Mr. Pilot.
You know, most of us up here, when we campaign,
part of our campaign platform has been increased business, reduce the burden on the taxpayers. That being said, we have to be reasonable and logical and how we make that growth happen, where it happens. And I think, as Mr. Krant said, we have to work with those residents and do everything reasonable that we can do to try to alleviate some of the impact on them. Everybody wants reduced taxes, but it's always not in my backyard. I understand that. And we will do everything that we can working with you guys, those neighbors that would be impacted by something like this. But as Mr. Kernan mentioned, everybody around us is growing. Certain growth is good, you know. I mean, you look at some of the ways that areas flourish and it becomes overpopulated. That's a bad thing. But as long as we have controlled growth, that extra revenue is going to help pay for better roads within the city. I mean, we're spending over $1 million this year in roads alone. There's only 12,500 people in the city of Norton. You know, that makes it pretty tough to continue year after year unless we do something to make those changes. So this is our opportunity to make one of those changes. So I will be voting in favor of this. Thank you.
Further discussion?
Just briefly, I'm absolutely in favor of this. Just about any development that's legal and that's good for the city of Norton, no matter where it is, as long as it's good for the city of Norton as a whole, I'm 100% behind it, and that's all I have to say on it.
Thank you. Is there any further discussion regarding ordinance number 50-2019? Would the clerk call the roll, please?
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilott?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
No.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes. Ordinance number 51-2019. Ms. Wipke.
I offer ordinance 51-2019 for its third reading and ask the clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to provide for the issuance and sale of not to exceed $800,000 of notes of the City of Norton in anticipation of the issuance of bonds to pay costs of acquiring real property for municipal purposes and declaring an emergency.
Just for the public's clarification, this is for the monies to purchase the properties we just discussed. At this time, I motion to adopt Ordinance 51-2019.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second to adopt Ordinance 51-2019. Is there any further discussion? And just so that we're clear, a portion of the purchase price we're going to be paying for out of some funds that we have available. The $800,000 is a not-to-exceed number, the interest rate was somewhere around 2-3% at this point, correct, Mr. Messner? Okay. Any further discussion? Will the clerk call the roll, please?
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilott?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
No.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes. Ordinance number 52-2019, Mr. Towsley.
Thank you, Mr. President. I offer ordinance 52-2019 for its third reading and ask the clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of an agreement for the boarding of prisoners with the City of Barberton and declaring an emergency.
At this time, I'd like to make a motion to adopt ordinance 52-2019.
I'll second.
Have a motion and a second to adopt ordinance number 52-2019. Is there any discussion? And this, again, is the agreement that we are entering into with Barberton and, I think, Copley?
Yeah, each community is entering into the agreement, a separate agreement.
Separate agreements.
Services at the Barberton jail.
Okay, in order to keep the jail open.
That's correct.
All right. Any further discussion? Clerk, call the roll, please.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Mr. Pilott?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes. Amended Ordinance Number 54-2019, Mr. McGlone.
Thank you, Mr. President. I offer Amended Ordinance 54-2019 for its third reading. Ask clerk to read it, please.
An ordinance to amend the non-bargaining hourly wages for part-time police officers and declaring an emergency.
I move to adopt amended ordinance 54-2019.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to adopt amended ordinance number 54-2019. Is there any further discussion?
Yes, Mr. President. Just to get us in line with other cities, part-time police officers, the starting salary for less than 1 year of completed service will start to $18.66, and we'll go all the way up to, if there's 15-year service, be $23.51, and there's some in between there also. So,
thank you. Is there any further discussion? Will the clerk call the roll, please?
Mr. McClone?
Yes.
Mr. Carrant?
Yes.
Mr. Gaynor?
Yes.
Mr. Towsley?
Yes.
Ms. Wipke?
Yes.
Mr. Pilott?
Yes.
Mr. Kernan?
Yes. Public service announcements, Mayor Zita.
Thank you. At this time, I would just like to announce once again that the Twin Brooks Garden Club will be having a plant sale this coming Saturday, May 18th, from 9 a.m. until 12 noon here at Columbia Woods Park Pavilion. They'll have perennials for shade, sun, plus herbs, daylilies, hostas, grasses, and much more. Most plants are all under $5. So please come out and support the Twin Brooks Garden Club this coming Saturday here at Columbia Woods.
Thank you. Are there any other public service announcements from the administration, from council? No, nothing further to come before council. Is there a motion to adjourn?
I motion.
Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
We're adjourned.